All right, welcome back everybody. Let's try to keep this video brief. What I want to do is show you a little bit about the F distribution and then show you how to compute or find the critical values. So look at the F ratio. Keep in mind it's comprised of mean square between over mean square within. In other words, variance between groups over variance within groups. The reason why I'm trying to make that clear is I want to make sure you remember that variance, remember that's S squared, is always positive. So if variance between groups is always positive, and variance within groups is always positive, then the F ratio must always be positive. So when the null hypothesis is true, we would expect that F ratio to be somewhere right around 1, because when the null hypothesis is true, there's no variability essentially between the groups. So the amount of variability that we see between the groups is about equal to the variability that we see within the groups. So in other words, F should be somewhere around 1. That's a small F value. But when there is quite a bit of variability between the groups, differences between the groups, then the null hypothesis is likely to be rejected because the F value will be statistically significantly greater than 1. So how much greater than 1 does it need to be? As you know, in order to figure that out, in order to find a critical value, we typically need to compute degrees of freedom. Because we understood once we started doing t-tests that the t-distribution changes its shape as we've measured more people. Well, the f-distribution changes its shape too based on its degrees of freedom, which is based on the number of people that we've measured, and it's also based on the number of groups we're comparing. Another thing you'll notice about this F distribution is that it's one-sided. You can say it's one-tailed, but it really makes more sense to think about it as one-sided. The reason why it's one-sided is because, like I said before, variance can only be positive, so the F ratio will always be positive. So really, we only have numbers on the positive end of the number line. And what we want to do right now is figure out where's the most extreme 5% cutoff, or for example, where's the most extreme 1% cutoff, because that would give us the critical value for an alpha of 0.05 or for an alpha of 0.01. And those alphas, as we've learned, are the alpha levels that we encounter most often. So let's just assume that we're in a situation where we have 4 and 56 degrees of freedom. Let me show you where that comes from, just the way I talked about these two different degrees of freedom values. You might recall from this ANOVA source table that we compute degrees of freedom between groups based on the number of groups minus 1, and we also compute degrees of freedom within groups based on the number of people overall minus the number of groups. So we have two important values for degrees of freedom. We do have degrees of freedom overall, degrees of freedom total, but in terms of finding the critical value, that's not important to us. So when you look right here at the top of the table, you see it says degrees of freedom in the numerator. And this tells you right here, degrees of freedom in the numerator equals degrees of freedom between groups. Right here it says degrees of freedom in the denominator. And this is helping you understand that degrees of freedom denominator is degrees of freedom within groups, which some people will refer to as degrees of freedom error. So where does that come from? Why are we talking about numerator denominator? And that's because if you look back here again at our F ratio, we're creating a fraction, right? And on the top, that's the numerator. Well, the numerator has all the information from the between groups source of variation. So degrees of freedom between groups is essentially associated with the numerator of this fraction. And then degrees of freedom within groups would be associated with the denominator of the fraction right over here. So at least that's where the terminology comes from. So when we have 4 and 56 degrees of freedom, it's 4 degrees of freedom in the numerator. So I'd be looking at this column right here. And then 56 degrees of freedom in the denominator. So I have to come down this column until I see the closest thing to 56 degrees of freedom. Check one, check one. Will I see a row for 50 degrees of freedom and a row for 60 degrees of freedom? When I align that with this column right here, I can see that the two values that I'm kind of thinking about would be maybe 2.56 or this 2.53 that you see highlighted. But clearly 56 is closer to 60 than it is 50. So we would select 2.53 in this case to be our critical value. Don't forget our class policy. We always look up the closest value. When two values are equally close, like if I had 55 degrees of freedom, I would always pick the value that requires more evidence. But in this situation, we have 56 degrees of freedom, and that's closest to 60. So it was kind of a no-brainer. Now, it turns out that the tables that we are using are specified for an alpha level. So this particular table is specified for an alpha of 0.05. And then we have a separate table for an alpha of 0.01. Let's just review those tables real quickly. They're posted online on our Blackboard site. You can easily print them out and have them at your side. So we're dealing with 4 and 56 degrees of freedom. Let's replicate what we just found in this table. Here's the table when we have an alpha of 0.05. This would be 4 degrees of freedom between groups. We'd want to find the closest thing to 56 within groups. We determined that the closest thing to 56 would be 60 degrees of freedom. So we come across this row until we hit this column, and you can see again there's that number, 2.53. Now, going back to where we were, you can see that this particular graph is labeled that when we're using an alpha of 0.01, it says the critical value would be at 3.65. So where does that come from? So now I'm going to click on the table that shows all the critical values based on an alpha level of 0.01. So again, we have 4 and 56 degrees of freedom. Here's 4 degrees of freedom in our numerator, 4 degrees of freedom between groups. We have 56 degrees of freedom within groups. The closest thing is 60. So if we come across this row until we hit that column, we see that value of 3.65. And then just to verify, 3.65 is what we have labeled right here, marking off the most extreme 1%. So it's very easy to find these critical values. It always is. We just have to compute degrees of freedom first. So now we're ready to compute our first example, and that's exactly what we're going to do in our next video. So in the meantime, take care.